Welcome back, dear viewers. Thank you so much for staying with us. You're watching this edition of The Breakfast Show live on Nile TV International. Now it's time for our first topic of discussion for today. And of course, the victory of Donald Trump in the 2016 U.S. presidential elections has stunned the world, and mixed reactions are pouring in for the victory of Trump. Some officials are shocked. On the other hand, others had welcomed the results of the 2016 U.S. presidential elections. And to shed more light on this topic, we're most delighted to be joined here in the studio by Dr. Yumna Hamay, Professor of Economics, Ain Shams University. First of all, good morning, Doctor.
Good
Thank
morning,
you so much for joining us.
Good morning, Doctor.
Good morning.
So, first of all, talking about this stunning win of Donald Trump, and of course, this will change the map, if we can say like this. Much concerned with the impact on the world economy, because nowadays we have many challenges, and Donald Trump has his own visions when it comes to in this respect.
Yes. You know, the first remark about the victory of Donald Trump is that the world is witnessing nowadays, you know, tendency against globalization. If you analyze the situation, the political situation worldwide, you are going to find that, the right wing is always winning in Europe. And here in the case in Trump, what do we mean by the right wing? It means that Donald Trump against immigration, Donald Trump against all types of free international trade, against climate change. You know, which means that I believe that the main reason for his victory is that he is saying to Americans, we would like to return back the glory of America. You know, the same scenario has been done in the UK situation when, the Brexit. It's the same meaning that globalization affected people negatively. And from here it comes, no, we are going to be concerned of ourselves. We are going to think about ourselves only. Is affecting negatively the way of life, the opportunity of jobs. And from here it comes that we have to think just about America. I believe this is the tendency that made Americans voting for Trump. Because they would like, to return back the glory of America. They would like to be, safe and protected against terrorism. Part of it is the immigration, so we have to contain immigration. Trade agreements like the NAFTA among the three countries, Mexico and United States and Canada. If the trade coming from Mexico affecting the opportunities of job of Americans, so we have to make some control. We are going to put barriers of trade or protection against this product so that to keep, or to support American labor. So the issue is that Trump succeeded to gather Americans for one meaning, which is it's of our interests of Americans that we are going to take care of. And from here it comes that, he got this victory.
Yes. Speaking about labor, Dr. Yumna, Trump has vowed that he will create more jobs for the Americans, and also that he will decrease the free trade, as you said. What would be the, first of all, regarding the employment, do you believe that he will fulfill his promise? And on the other hand, about China, do you believe that he will indeed stop trade, and what will be the repercussions of such a decision?
You know that this is bad news regarding the liberalization of trade. Mm-hmm. You know that liberalization of trade, and which is completely supported by WTO, World mm-hmm. Trade Organization, mm-hmm. You know, has affected seriously the world economy, from that it gave China the opportunity to be the second largest economy and the first exporter in the world. This is due to the liberalization of trade and opening markets, you know, mm-hmm. and addressing all barriers of trade. From here it comes that after the financial crisis, there was tendency towards protectionism, since each country would like to support its economy by putting some barriers against trade. Mm-hmm. And from here it comes that the world is witnessing nowadays a downturn in international trade. With Trump, we are expecting that this tendency is going to increase. Mm-hmm. Why? Because, you know, the major exporters and importers are United States and China. Mm-hmm. From here it comes if Trump is going to address protectionism regarding, you know, American companies, multinationals working in China, because the relation is that multinationals, American multinationals, are working in China, opening factories, and they are exporting their product to the United States. From here it comes that, you know, the balance of trade between United States and China is completely for the benefit of of China and against United States. But this is compensated by large flows from China into United States, which means that there is balanced relationship regarding economic situation. The issue is if Trump is going to put some protectionist action against this trade coming from Chinese companies or coming from China into United States, I believe this will affect seriously you know, the flow of trade and reduce, you know, the growth of trade, international trade, generally speaking. But I don't believe that he can do to a large extent. Why? Because, you know, when it comes to the interest of businessmen and women, you know, all over the world, and specifically, you have to remember that Trump is a businessman. So from here it comes that if it's going to affect the American economy, I don't think that, you know, this will happen. Besides, United States is not, you know, a country, the decision is made only by the president. We know quite well that there are institutions and they have their say towards taking decisions. So from here it comes that maybe these are more slogans to attract people rather than being, you know, being able to implement this this issue. So I don't believe that he is going, maybe he can put some, you know, barriers, maybe he can make some, you know, a kind of, you know, redistribution of income.
Or limiting.
Among, yes, some decision can be made in order just to make it not like increasing tendency towards this type of export to United States. But I don't think that Trump is capable to make such protectionism, because it affected seriously the American economy and the interest of businessmen, and I believe that this is quite hard for him to do that.
Well, talking about the Middle East as well, because of course he has different relations from Obama, different views from Clinton, and when it comes, for example, to the Gulf states, when it comes to the oil prices, how do you see it from this respect?
You know, the Gulf state, actually, they were supporting Hillary Clinton. And, you know, I think that they fund, you know, Hillary Clinton. So from here it comes that to how extent what we are talking about the price of oil, you don't
as an
expect
example.
That this price is going to increase for the coming period because the market is quite, you know, predicted for the coming periods regarding the tendency of increase of oil because, you know, very complicated calculations regarding oil price. But regarding the relationship between United States and the Middle East, Trump has mentioned that he would like to make some kind of cooperation among all countries of the world. The Middle East is not in the interest of the United States nowadays. United States has changed completely the direction of the importance of the Middle East. Nowadays, United States turned into Iran, into other alliances.
Is this good
that
or bad?
Are coping with her interest or its interest. You know, this is urging Arab countries to make something, you know, because all the time, if you are, you know, affected without acting, you know, so the issue is to how extent Arab countries can, you know, unify their visionary approach towards relation with United States, and they can use their power because Arab countries have very, you know, the opportunities to use their power to cope with United States as a unit, not as country by country. Mm-hmm. From here it comes, you know, the predictions for the coming period is quite related to how extent Arab countries can unify their effort. But economically, from the economic point of view, you know that the Arab countries are facing serious, you know, challenges regarding economic situation. Saudi Arabia and nowadays suffering from a deficit in the budget, severe deficit. And, you know, United Arab Emirates and Qatar, you know, there are severe problems due to the decrease in the oil price. So from here it comes, what are the real alliances? How the world in and the world economy is witnessing so to how extent Arab countries can, you know, present themselves on the world economy map as a power. I don't think that, you know, we have several economic conferences in order to support SMEs, in order to try to enhance, you know, mutual investment. Till now, you know, efforts are not having their results to the right way.
Mm-hmm. Professor, speaking about Egypt, do you believe that the election of Trump will make a or will open a new era in the relations between the two countries?
I believe that so much because even if you return back to the meeting of President Sisi in New York with Trump and Hillary Clinton, you can see the difference, you know, the different presentation of Hillary compared to Trump. Trump was looked opening, was looked as presenting himself and as, you know, presenting that he is offering cooperation. And I believe that this is quite well for Egypt for this period. I believe that we can enhance our relation with United States. We have a lot of issues to be discussed regarding, you know, attracting American investors to come here to Egypt, specifically when we have nowadays access of Suez Canal and a lot of areas that are opened for, you know, unexploited resources. So this is a very good opportunity. We have here American companies that are making very large profits from being investing in Egypt. So this is a good opportunity for that. At the same time, I don't know if we can renew opening the negotiations regarding free trade agreement between Egypt and the United States. We have been discussing this for a long, long period, and it has been sterilized completely for the last period because of our relation. But still, there is opportunity in order to regain our relation with United States, which I believe it's quite important because United States is the largest economy in the world. They have technology. We can cooperate in different fields. And here, this is a new era for our relations because with Hillary Clinton, it was completely blocked from my point of view. You know, Hillary Clinton participated in different decisions that affected Egypt seriously and negatively. Mm-hmm. So I believe that for Egypt, this is a good news that Trump came. Hopefully we can invest on it. But I don't think Trump is good news for, climate change and SDGs, Sustainable Development Goals. Nowadays there is a conference in Morocco discussing the implementation of the climate change decision of Paris 2015. We are about to activate this agreement. And the world is witnessing nowadays achieving sustainable development goals in which developing countries are having serious problems about transfer of technology. You know that the decision of Paris is to keep the temperature of the Earth into not higher than 2 degrees. So in order to do that, there are several steps that should be taken in mitigation and adaptation, including if you are going to concentrate on renewable energy, it means that we have to transfer technology. Here in the Middle East, we have very good opportunities, specifically for Egypt, regarding solar energy and wind energy. But still, till now, we are importing the technology. So in order to transfer technology and to benefit from these capabilities, Morocco benefited from it better than us. Morocco is they have inaugurated one of the largest solar energy project. Egypt was expecting to have this project. Unfortunately, due to bureaucracy and corruption, we lost the opportunity of this, but there are other projects that are on the pipeline in order to be implemented. So hopefully that specifically after the decisions of the Higher Council of Investment, in which there is a mechanism of complaint and for investors who are suffering from any problems, and it's going to be revised, there is going to be a very important tendency on one-stop shop, on facilitating all processes to start business. So there is a tendency in Egypt in order to facilitate and to make environment for investment more reasonable and attractive. Hopefully that we can proceed on that. In order to open opportunities for investment, because I believe that regarding renewable energy, we have nowadays 18 companies, multinationals, that are coming to Egypt to work in this field, because Egypt is one of the most important countries regarding solar energy. We can generate electricity from solar energy, and this is quite important in order to make this expansion. We have the 1.5 million fadans, and solar energy is one asset in order to implement this the reclamation of 1.5 million fadans. So a lot of opportunities for Egypt in different fields, not only in renewable energy, but they are integrated in renewable energy, agricultural product for the agriculture sector and for the industrial, enhancing the industrial base. This is for Egyptians. What I believe is the main challenge for this government and the civil society is how to make all these opportunities translated for the benefit of people. And when you are putting this question mark, I believe there is a great effort that should be done in order to attract youth to come and to work and to find opportunities of work, still the efforts to do that are still very weak.
Well, of course, we always talk about that we cannot separate political issues and economic issues, of course. And they are just, it is one coin. So talking about economic situation in the Middle East, we have to take this into consideration. Well, of course, we will see new relations or new vision when it comes to the relation between United States and Russia.
Yes.
And of course, what is happening in Syria, of course, what is happening in Yemen, in these countries. And definitely this will affect the economy of the whole Middle East, because what is happening, talking about terrorism, extremism, all what is taking place, for sure, this is affecting our economy as well. You believe this, we're going to see something that is completely different or unexpected?
You know, not completely different, but I agree with you that, you know, the situation is going to be better because, you know, the conflict between United States and Russia has been exaggerated for the last period. So if we can have some kind of cooperation between the United States and Russia, this will be reflected on the whole situation in the Middle East, specifically regarding the conflict between United States and Russia regarding Syria, for example. It's for our quite interest in Egypt that to have Syria settle down, the situation to be solved, you know. The crisis that Syria is living in, the same for Yemen, the same for Libya.
And with this, he will solve
this is
the making, idea
yes,
of
this is
immigration.
Making the area quite, you know, unstabilized. So from here it comes that if we have this kind of, a cooperation and harmonizing, you know, points of view regarding this severe conflict, I believe this could make the situation better regarding more, you know, more stabilization in the area, and this can have a very good and positive impact on Egypt.
Dr. Yumna Hamai, thank you so much for your insight. Dr. Yumna Hamai, Professor of Economics at Shamsia University, thanks so much for being with us. Dear viewers, now we move on to a short break and we'll resume later the remaining segments of The Breakfast Show live on Mile TV International.